Welcome to this video, you guys. I'm just going to be going through my worst purchases of 2022. I can't believe we're at the end of 2022 here. I've kind of done this since 2019. I was looking back and I will say it's interesting. I feel like things can shift. So like maybe one of my worst purchases this year could be one of my favorites next year. Cause I look back in 2019 or 2020, I said my air fryer was one of my worst purchases. And now I could argue that's one of my best purchases cause I use it so much. I just like didn't know how to use it. At first or wasn't using it that much. This video isn't sponsored or anything, so these are all just like truly my opinions. Why don't you grab a drink with me, grab a snack. I have a poppy in my wine glass because I wanted to grab a glass of wine and be like, let's have a drink. This is like late night edition because I just thought of all of these right here now and I'm like, let's just do it. But I didn't feel like drinking, so poppy it is for me. Oh, my poppies are my best purchases. So without further ado, let's just get into my worst purchases. I have five worst purchases. We're gonna end on a positive note. I have five of my best purchases. And it's interesting because I went through my over 1,000 Amex transactions thus far this year. I think it was something like 1,200. Like that is bad. We gotta cut back next year on all the little things here and there, I'm thinking. But what's interesting is most of these I could recall off the top of my head. Like I feel like your most favorite things that you bought during the year and the things that you were like, oh, I regret it, I'm cringing, can kind of like you remember, you know, is like in the front of your memory. I have my list right here if you see me like looking at my phone. Okay, let's do it. Okay, first worst purchase. I purchased this less than a week ago. So take this with a grain of salt. The reason I'm thinking this is one of my worst purchases this year is because this is called the Pure Lift Face. I got this at, oh, Brody was laying. Hi. You were my best purchase ever. Don't worry, honey. I got this at Face Gym in LA. I don't know if they sell it other places or if it's just from Face Gym. Face Gym, don't hate me. I'm not talking crap about you. I had like a really good experience there. The reason I'm thinking this is one of my worst purchases is because I think the whole thing with this, I think it's kind of like a face, like it's like a advanced non-invasive facelift. Well, visibly lifts, sculpts, tightens, tones. Like it's like a patented muscle stimulation technology. Activate and elevate your facial muscles. Whatever, they used it on me when I had my facial there and it just is like tightens and tones your face and looks really good. Sydney and I were sold and we got them, but they were very expensive. And I think the whole thing with these is you have to be consistent. You have to use them like every other day to notice results. And I haven't used it yet. It is still in the box. I literally haven't opened it. So if that tells you anything, I feel like this is just gonna be one of my worst purchases because it was like a couple hundred dollars. And I'm like, that was stupid. And in the moment, I'm noticing a common theme here with my worst purchases. A lot of them are, actually no, not a lot of, well, I guess some of them are just spontaneous in the moment. But if I really like slept on it, I'd probably be like, maybe not, maybe I'll pass. Oh, by the way, I was gonna change before this. I'm realizing I'm in this sweater. But you know, this is like kind of like Christmassy and wintry looking and fun. This is just my management, like, this is a sweater with the name of my management on it. Tape Rock Management, shout out. Love them, best management ever. Next up, worst purchases. See, this makes me feel bad. Cause these would arguably have been my best for the past like 3 years. They probably were even on there. Now they're turning to worst purchases. This is every mascara that I purchased this year that isn't this one is worst purchase because I don't use them anymore because this is the best mascara ever and I am never turning back. And this makes me sad to say, some of you were probably like, but Gretchen, you've literally talked about Benefit Roller Lash and this new waterproof one I got more recently in L'Oreal Telescopic for years. Yes, I have. They're really great mascaras. If they work for you, that's great and wonderful and perfect. They did for me for so long and I love them and I think they're really great mascaras. However, I started to run into an issue where my mascara, which by the way, this makeup has been on my face for like 12 hours, so it's probably looking a little scary. Pimples fully saying hello. Anyway, I'm saying that my mascara started to run underneath my eyes and the waterproof one, not waterproof ones, all the ones I was trying, it would run under my eyes and I couldn't fix it and I didn't know what to do until you guys were commenting in my video, you need to try tubing mascara because it's like formulated differently. Like if normal mascaras work for you, those are my favorites. But if you have the problem where they run under your eyes, like I don't know if that's a common thing or like just me. Clearly it's not just me. Cause I think that's why tubing mascara was made, which is what this is. This is the Thrive Cosmetics Liquid Lash Extensions. This literally is the only mascara I use now ever since I got it like 2 months ago. It's like the only one I'm ever gonna use again. I think it's only on their website. Thrive, if you wanna work together, please let me know because I'm literally your number one fan now. And I think they even have like a subscription available on their website. And I'm like, I'm about to do that because I will not be okay without this because it doesn't run under my eyes. It's formulated differently. Why don't I take a video when I take off my makeup in a little bit so you guys can see what I'm talking about. I'm talking so long about this because it's literally changed my life. Like, that sounds so dramatic, but taking off my makeup is 100 times quicker because it comes off with water. Like, I literally rub my eyes with water and it just flakes off, yet somehow it doesn't run underneath my eyes. I don't understand. I've had this mascara on for 12 hours, and if it was any of these, by the end of the day, I think maybe I just have really like oily like eyelids, I don't know. It would be like black like raccoon eyes underneath my eyelids. Does anyone get that? But I don't get that with this mascara, and this mascara is just so good at like lengthening, stays on so well, but somehow right when you rub it with water, it just all comes off. So it makes taking your makeup off 100 times easier. It's the best mascara ever. I was supposed to talk about that later when I talked about, but any mascara that wasn't that one was basically a waste of money for me. If you guys want these and live near me, come to, well, I use them a little bit, but that's gross. But yeah, those weren't good purchases because now I have my new favorite, and I'll just give those to like friends if they want them and don't care that I tried. Okay, next up we have, this isn't exactly a terrible purchase, but more so a fee, a penalty, if you will. I thought I would include this. I thought this would be worthwhile to remind you to be on top of your shit. Be, just prioritize what's a priority. Be an adult, okay? Be mature and organized when it comes to finances and adulting and all those things. Because only you, as an adult, are gonna like keep you on track with that stuff. It's like no one's there to remind you like, hey, don't be late on this, do this. It's like you're the adult, you have to like take care of it on your own, which sometimes seems like an enormous responsibility. But what I'm trying to say is, yes, some very expensive penalties I had to pay would be regarding taxes earlier this year. But luckily, I will say that that is probably the last time I'll be paying penalties for paying taxes, paying estimates late, because I'm in my on top of my game era, okay? Literally for the past year and a half, it seems like I've been in the transition. No one asks, no one cares, but I've transitioned from being the 1099er, independent contractor situation, which is what I've done forever, and it's like one of the most expensive ways you can file your taxes, and that's just what I knew in the simplest way, and that's what it was. Made sense for a while, stopped making sense. Switched everything over to an S corporation, I believe. This is where it starts to get a little hairy, and I don't really know what I'm talking about, but yeah, I'm in my on top of my game era because I had to get myself on payroll and learn what payroll is and how to do that and what am I gonna make my salary. And it's 1,000 times better now because my taxes get taken out. I think I pay myself bi-weekly, but suddenly I'm an employer and the sole employee of that employer, and trying to figure all that out has been kind of crazy. But needless to say, now I take out my own taxes like every other week, whereas before, if any of you are 1099ers and you know the struggle of having to pay quarterly, and if you're late on that, penalties, which is what always happened to me in the past. In college, I was a hot mess. I'd once a year pay all the penalties for not any of my estimates, and I probably didn't even have enough money to pay my taxes at the end of the year because it doesn't get taken out for you when you're a 1099er. If you work on social media, then you are, you know, if any of you are content creators, you know. And then I would spend every penny that would come my way and not have enough to pay taxes, and it was horrible. But now I, I'm grinding and I'm doing better and I have that all set up well. But that is a whole lot of ways to say that, yeah, paying penalties for your taxes is no fun. You know what else isn't fun is paying for an accountant. You know what, let's add that in the worst. You know, that's the worst purchase and the best purchase because I literally could not live without them, but worst purchase because it is so gosh dang expensive. No one tells you that when you're growing up, like, hey, you will probably need an accountant one day and they are so expensive. Well, I guess it depends on like what exactly you're doing for work, but if your taxes get very confusing because you have multiple streams of income and blah, 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 like me, you need a really good accountant and it's worth it, and like they do all my bookkeeping and everything, but it's just so... But yeah, I would literally be nothing without them. So, okay, next up we have restaurants. I would say it would have to be one of my worst purchases just overall as a category, because believe it or not, over a quarter of my transactions were eating out, which you'd almost think would maybe be more, but like that was over, I believe it was like 275 around there, transactions eating out. I'm like, wait, that is literally, I didn't even put that in perspective. We're probably like 350 days into the year. That is bad. That is so bad. That's like an average of almost one every day. Like, I eat out a lot, and I'm gonna change that in 2023, okay? Because, you know, I don't regret all the like social fun dinners and when I'm traveling and stuff like that. Like, I'm always down to have like a big fun dinner with friends and stuff. I don't regret that. What I do regret in that category is all like the Postmates and the Uber Eats and the I'm gonna go grab lunch and I'm just gonna go pick up dinner. And it's like, no, I have food in the fridge that's probably rotting that I should just cook, but I get lazy. And yeah, 2023 is gonna be the year of me being responsible when it comes to that. I didn't actually think about in my head how that's pretty much eating out. That's more eating out more than every other day. Oh, I guess Starbucks transactions were probably in there. And so like, and so some days it's like, you know, I eat out lunch and dinner in Starbucks. So that's like three in a day. But like, yeah, that adds up quick. That category was really expensive. Okay, last up, you're probably like, huh? But let me explain. My fifth and final worst purchase of 2023 is this phone right here. This exact phone. Wait, did I say 2023? 2022. Okay. Yeah, no one asked. I'm gonna try not to tell like the whole long story, but I went about it in the wrong, complete wrong way. I feel like I made many mistakes along the way. So please learn from me. If you're watching this, if you're like, I need a new phone, I'm about to do this, listen to what I have to say first. My 11 Pro Max that I had for like over 3 years, just suddenly and inexplicably, long story short, broke. In the beginning of September, like August 31st, September 1st, like right around there, right? Like literally 2 weeks before the iPhone 14 came out. So I was in a pickle because I'm like, of course, now I want the 14. That's the new one that's coming out. But I literally cannot wait 2 weeks. Like my management, Tabora, is like, hey, send us, you know, analytics from this sponsored Instagram post. And I'm like, hey, my phone doesn't work. I can't. So it's like, you guys know, I work on my phone every day. Like I needed a phone right then and there. And I was desperate because my phone stopped working and the screen was barely working. Like half the screen was working. And it, if you missed it, go listen to my podcast. Hopefully some of you heard it. It's kind of scary, but I guess I'm just telling the whole story now. But it was like 2 days before I moved out of my Boston apartment this summer, and my phone was sitting on the counter, did not move. 30 minutes later, I walked literally just like this, face up, and I'm like, what the heck happened to it? And it was like point of impact right here, and then cracks across the screen, and the bottom half of my screen didn't work. And Lucy, my friend Taylor, Maddie were there. I'm like, guys, what happened there? Like, we didn't even go over there. And my vacuum fell like across the apartment, and I'm like, that's the only explanation. The vacuum fell on my phone. That's just what I'm gonna go with, because this is really creepy and we have no explanation. And I kept saying that, and then Lucy was like, Gretchen, the vacuum fell like around the corner. Like, it did not fall anywhere near your phone. And I'm like, okay, well, I'm scared, so I'm just gonna go with that. And then you guys were telling me that it, ooh, I can't say this, I'm here alone and it's late and now I need a glass of wine. You guys were telling me that it was paranormal activity. Now I'm feeling weird. I feel like I can't even say that. Ooh, it's okay, Gretchen. I gotta pray. That was happening to my phone because I saw psychic, and that apparently that happens if you see psychic and you go against like your destiny, that paranormal activity can come after your technology. I don't know. I didn't say it. I got comments like that, and when I first saw that, I was so scared because guess what happened the day before? If you guys didn't hear the story, or if you did, I'm sorry, but if you didn't, like, it's actually crazy. The day before, my friend Taylor, who referred me to the psychic, same psychic she went to, I went to, day before, she has her phone sitting up on a table like this, comes over and is like, why is my phone cracked? What happened? And we're all like, your phone has not moved. We have no idea. And it was a crack. It was a point of impact right here. Same lower right hand corner, cracks across the screen. Same exact crack, exactly one day before mine, and like no explanation. So that was really creepy. Needless to say, needed a new phone right away. I was scared and I had to get a 13 because the 14 hadn't come out yet. Couldn't wait, whatever. I go right to Apple and I'm like, I need to buy a 13 right here now. And they're like, girl, don't, the 14 comes out in 2 weeks. And I was like, yeah, I'm not gonna make it without a phone, so I have to, and this stinks. And they were like, okay, do you wanna do like a payment plan, pay it all up front, whatever. And I remember with my last phone, the 11, I had a payment plan and I had like just barely finished paying it off before I had to buy this phone. So I was like, you know what? Let's just like get it all over and done with. It doesn't have to loom over my head. Let's just like pay right here and now. And I have to get the most expensive, most storage one because I have 130,000 photos on my phone, which is a whole other issue. And of course I'm gonna get Apple Care because I don't wanna be in the same situation I was before. And so they're like, okay, your total comes to $2,000. It was like a little bit over $2,000. When I tell you, I went about this all the wrong way. My first thing that I did wrong was not trying to trade in my 11 at all. I just assumed since like the screen wasn't really working that I couldn't, but I should have replaced the screen, like the glass, and that, because it might have just been because the glass was broken, or maybe the screen actually was broken and I couldn't have traded in, but I should have tried, because then my sister's like, oh, what? You had to pay $2,000 for a phone? Like, I just got the 14 and I traded in my old broken 11. They gave me like $800 and I did it at AT&T and they always have a deal, so it's like cheaper and you pay like $5 a month for the next however many years that it just adds on top of your bill. So it's like way more affordable and way better idea. And I'm like, I literally did all of this so wrong. So please learn from me. Don't do what I did. Go to your carrier, trade in your last phone. They'll give you a better deal than Apple will anyway, and have the payment plan. Well, I guess pay it up front. I don't know. I guess that just depends on what you want. But I regret that because I think I did it all in the wrong way. And also what I should have done, I don't know if this is bad, but I should have just like used it for a week or two, like within the return policy. Should have returned the 13 and like got the 14, because what the heck, it was 2 weeks before. Anyway, I'm talking so long about my worst purchases. Clearly they're like emotional to me. Okay, we have two more that are like bonus that I thought of after I made this list. Ready? This ring right here. Oh, see, I already feel bad saying this. No, this is one of my best, but it's also one of my worst. Let me tell you why. It was very spontaneous and one of the most expensive items I've ever purchased. So you can just interpret that how you will. This ring was so fucking expensive. One of the best, because see, I feel both sides of it. One of the best, it was spontaneous. I went to the mall and I decided, you know what? My baby cousin, who I'm so close with, who literally feels like an immediate family member to me, one of Lucy's my closest friends, we've known her and loved her forever, Mandy, was graduating from college and I was like, you know what? I'm gonna get her this ring. It's gonna be so special and I'm gonna get myself the matching one and we're cousins and we'll always remember. I don't know. It just is like sentimental to me and means a lot. But then I'm like, Gretchen, that is the most expensive thing you've ever spent. And like when I look back this year and I sort by like how expensive things are, this is like up there. This is like one of the most expensive. So I'm like, it kind of makes me sweat. Like that was a lot. But then also like I love it for our memories. I love it. I'll keep it forever. But maybe I regret it a little because it's just so expensive. Like I probably could have got one that like just looked like it, you know? Anywho, last bonus first purchase. You guys are like, can you tell us what you actually liked? This is so not like me to be like negative. So I'm like defending every worst purchase when in reality I'm like, okay. Last little bonus is a lot of these things are not like things. They're like, not physical things. This is another fee, so learn from my mistakes, people. Me and my best friends, this should be on the best purchase list, but I just thought of like physical things. Me and my besties, Lucy, went to Hawaii in February, and this is like a big trip for us because they all have normal jobs, not like me, and like obviously I just mean mine is so flexible, and theirs aren't, so they had to like plan way ahead, request their time off, save up. Like it was like such a big trip for all of us to go to Hawaii together, and it was so much fun. That was definitely one of my best purchases. One of the worst things that came from it was, I won't name drop the hotel, but one hotel. So we go to a bunch of different hotels and at just one of them we had a problem. You'd assume with like a room with two queen beds, however they do it, is for four people, like two in each. I've done that at so many hotels. I've never had an issue. We all just wanted to stay together. We're like four besties. This one hotel, we're checking in and they're like, oh no, you can only have like two people in here. And we're like, well, there's four of us. And they're like, oh no, we can't even allow more than three and you have to pay like a charge. And so we're like, wait, what the heck? We were not told this at all. And I'd stayed there before when I'd gone to Hawaii and I was just like, what the heck is happening? So it was a whole mess and we had to pay like hundreds more each night because we were over the maximum quantity, occupancy of people that they allow in their rooms for whatever reason. It was just four of us. It was fine at every other hotel, but this one hotel gave us a really hard time. I never saw that on their website booking or anything, so I had no idea. And yeah, that was a fee that definitely would have been avoidable if we, I think it must have still been cheaper than having two separate rooms, or else we would have just done that. Maybe we would have just stayed somewhere else. I don't know. But yeah, that was like a tough one. So make sure if you're going somewhere with your friends that you like really make sure before that's okay. Yeah, I don't know how we were not aware of that at all. Okay, now that we have the ick out, let's move on to my best purchases of 2022. Is this how I've done it in years past? I may have like alternated in years past, like worst purchase, best purchase. But we just did all the worst ones first and now we're gonna do the best ones. These we can kind of speed through because you guys know, you've probably seen them all year. I probably haven't shut up about them. Okay, number one, the Stanley Cup. I always feel like, unfortunately, it is worth the hype. Unfortunately, because it's just so hyped up that you wanna be like, oh no, it's not worth the hype, but like it is. And I always think it's expensive, but really it's like not that expensive if you think about the fact that you're gonna use it every single day. I use this every single day, so worth it. And making you more hydrated every day is priceless. I'm like selling it to you. I'm like, buy this. No, but actually if you don't have this, buy it. Like you should. I'll link the best ones in the description. I probably won't link the worst ones because I don't recommend them. No, but I do recommend these mascaras. Benefit, don't hate me. Benefit is one of my favorite makeup brands. Like so much of the makeup I use is Benefit. Now I just don't use their mascara because I found a better one in my opinion. But like, yeah. Ooh, now I feel bad about the ones I talked bad about. I'm sorry, girl. Okay, what was I saying? Stanley Cup. Literally, best purchase ever. If you don't have it, get it. You're welcome. And everyone is always like, oh my gosh, it's like bigger than I thought. It's 40 ounces. It's huge, okay? But you're gonna drink that much more water. Like if you fill up two of these a day, you're doing pretty good. If you fill up three, you're amazing. You're so hydrated. So they keep your water really cold. The straw, they fit in your cup holder because they're skinnier at the bottom. Also, if you're like Gretchen, 40 ounces is literally massive. Like if you think about it, I feel like people don't realize how big they are. Like the 32 ounce water bottles that are pretty big, like a Nalgene, like a Hydro Flask, the 32 ounce ones. Like this is bigger than that. This is so big. But they have a 30 ounce option available as well. You need it. Link down below. I really want a second one. We will see. I've been like dropping hints to Max. I'm like, there's this really pretty light pink one that like I would love. We will see if I get it. Next up, if I've talked about these in years past about being best purchases, you know these are like my ride or die. This I have to include because I put these on my body every single day. I'm wearing them right now. Grabbed another pair to show you. I probably have 6 or 7 to be honest, but I need 7. I need one for every day of the week because I put them on my body every single day. The Lululemon Align leggings, I live in them. I cannot live without them. If I'm wearing a different pair, I always wish that I was just wearing these. They're just the best leggings ever, okay? I wake up and I unconsciously open my leggings drawer, pull out a black pair of Align leggings, put them on every single day. Every single day. I walk my dog in them. I work out in them. I dress them up. I don't really do that. But like I wear them every single day, okay? They always make sense to wear them. You honestly could dress them up. You could wear them as like tights. No one would know. Oh my gosh. Put a dress, put on your little like booties, and they probably just look like opaque tights. They're so soft. They're so stretchy. They're so comfy. Great quality. We love them. You guys have heard me talk about them forever, but seriously, if you don't have a pair, I'm concerned. Are you okay? You need them. You are not okay without them, actually. Okay, Thrive Mascara. I already told you, you also need this. Just try it. Even if you have one that you love and you're like, Gretchen, no, I have my favorite mascara. It's the Roller Lash that you've told me to buy for years. That's great, honey. Keep using that. But, honey, I beg that I just called you honey. You're like, okay, Karen, don't be rude. I could just have a conversation with myself all day. It's so concerning. Okay, Thrive Mascara. Actually though, just try it. I feel like Thrive Cosmetics, that I tried their makeup like years ago, but I don't think I ever tried the mascara because it is, I mean people, it is like life changing. Like I am not kidding, taking off my makeup is 10 minutes quicker at the end of the day because I'm not sitting there with a makeup wipe scrubbing off my mascara. I literally go like this with water. I mean you saw, I took a video. It's just, it's incredible. It is annoying, I will say. It's not on Amazon. I literally went to Target the first time that my friend was like, because my friend always liked it too, and so I was like, okay, I'm gonna get it at Target, and then it wasn't there, and they literally only have it on their website, but it is the best mascara ever, okay? It's not even like up for debate. Next best purchase, Barefoot Dreams blanket. Also think I've talked about these before, but I also cannot live without this. The older I get, the more I realize adults are just big babies. And let me tell you why. Well, for a number of reasons. I mean, look at how adults behave. But this blanket, like I'm not okay without it. It makes me sleep better. I know that sounds insane, but I cannot sleep without it now. This is what I mean. I'm just a big baby. I need my blankie to sleep with. It's just so comfy, okay? It's so cozy. This is like one of my most recent ones. I probably have like 8. I'm not kidding. I have them all over my apartment. If you come here, you know it's a cozy wonderland, okay? You get the vibe. And if you don't, that's okay. But it's just the best blankie ever. It's so soft. Someone usually tries to steal it from me. Are you chewing on your daddy bear? And sometimes I share if I'm being nice. It's just so good, okay? You need it. This is one of the big ones that they have a Nordstrom that are like a little bit crazy expensive, but I'm also gonna link the Nordstrom rack version. It's just like a little bit smaller, more of like a throw blanket, and they are like a fraction of the price. They're so, so good. Definitely start there. Oh, here, see, I don't even know if you'll be able to tell. They're really not that much smaller at all, and full price, they're just so expensive. Like, this is a bigger one. This is just a little bit smaller, if you can see. This one is from Nordstrom Rack, again, like third of price, and I also love this. This is my most recent version of this one, and I also, like, I would take this just to sleep with too. Oh, they're so soft and cozy. They make me feel, like, safe and at home. Okay, next up, these deserved a moment because these are definitely my most worn. I like how I'm focusing on pants. I feel like I'm not a pants girly. I'm always getting like new tops and sweatshirts and stuff, but it's like, it's almost like I don't ever change up my pants because I'm just wearing these. These need to be on here because they're the best jeans ever, okay? Abercrombie 90s jeans, again, if you don't have these, you're not okay without them and you need them. I am the most dramatic person alive, but I mean it. You need to try them because I was an Goldie jean girly for years and I love them too. Don't get me wrong, but they are like more than double the price of these jeans. And I'm like, wait a minute, wait a minute. These are even better because there's more color options and distressing options, like different styles of it. They come in different inseams, which is a game changer. If you are short or tall or really short or really tall or normal, they have literally five. I think they have extra short, short, normal, tall, extra tall. So we love that. I get the tall version and it's spectacular because I'm 5'9 and jeans are always like capris on me, but my camera turned off. Wow, your girl can talk. Okay, wrap it up, Gretchen. I'm losing it, aren't I? These are just the best jeans, okay? Because they're really flattering. I think they're more flattering than the Goldies, even though the Goldies are so much more expensive. Like, those are really great quality, don't get me wrong. But these always have a little bit more, like, of a stretch to them. So I feel like they hug you a little bit better and are just so dang flattering, okay? And they're comfy. And these are the jeans that I've worn the most this year. I know, because they're always the ones I reach for, okay? Last but not least, if you stayed to the end of this video, you're getting a little treat because I have a secret that I have not said on social media. And now I'm getting nervous. I'm getting a little scared, to be honest, to talk about this. But if you made it to the end, you're a real one. So I guess I'll tell. I don't know why I've had this weird in my head. I'm like, I'm not gonna tell them for like a year. And then I'll be like, I guess what I didn't tell you for a year. Okay. Let's start with this, because this we all know about, because I documented it. One of my best purchases this year was lip filler. And you're probably gonna be like, Gretchen, ugh, that's so, ugh. People have all sorts of opinions on that type of stuff. My opinion on that kind of stuff is you do you, and do what you wanna do, and don't worry about what anyone else thinks, because it doesn't matter, because it's you and your body and your face, and you're the one that has to live with yourself, and at the end of the day, you have you, and if you're looking in the mirror, or do social media for a living, and looking at videos and pictures of you all day, and wanna change something about yourself, you should be able to, okay? Okay. I just have so many opinions on that, but I've thought about my lips for years, and if you look at my mom and my aunt and my sister and my cousin, we all just don't have top lips. That's just how we are as a family. And I think that's a common thing, to just have small lips. Like, obviously it's probably one of the number one things that people do is like get lip filler. And mine is so natural, okay? Anyone that doesn't like really notice or pay attention or look at me before, like, no one can even tell that I've really gotten it. It is so natural, but I love it for me. And so it just makes me so happy and is worth every penny. And it sounds stupid, but I was literally like, I like makeup and I like the lip liner that I buy and the lip gloss and stuff. And I feel like you can't see it. And maybe that's dumb, but I was like, I'm gonna get lip filler so that when I do my makeup, I can actually see my lip product. And I have a top lip now, but it's so natural, okay? So we love it, and it's worth every penny. And if you're wondering, if you didn't see when I documented the whole experience, I go to Dr. Waysar at Springhouse Dermatology outside of Philly. So yes, definitely recommend. Okay, lastly, worth every penny in my opinion, that is a big secret that I haven't talked about ever, that I'm spilling the secret right now, is I've gotten Botox a couple times. And no one has noticed, okay? See, that's my thing. People are like, ooh, don't get this done, don't get that done. You're gonna look crazy, you're gonna look like this. No one ever even notices, because it's subtle and natural and whatever. And now I just don't have wrinkles in my forehead and I notice it so much. My makeup goes on so smooth. It's the best thing ever. So we're talking like up here. I've gotten it 2 or 3 times now. And you never see me like really like Oh, well, I guess if you looked at old videos versus ones in the past couple months, you might be able to like, her face seems a little less expressive. But I had very strong forehead muscles before, like very, not deep 11s, I'm 25, but like if I could make that expression, it was very deep when I would do it. And like, I really started noticing it in the summer, I'd be squinting all the time because of the sun in my eyes. And I would notice like wrinkles there that would kind of stay for the rest of the day. And I'm like, let's just prevent this. Let's just not. And it's just something that I wanted to do. And I'm really happy that I did it and I love it. And I did it between my eyebrows. God, this pimple is driving me nuts. Can it not? But I got it between my eyebrows, up on my forehead. The first time I actually got it around my eyes right here, because my eyes squint a lot and I get lines right there. But I didn't really like it because I felt like a big part of my smile is that my eyes are like squint. And when they wouldn't do that, my smile would be like, so I stopped doing that. Okay. Here we go. I guess I can show you. This is my Botox reveal, but it's been a little bit, so I can probably move my face. Yeah, you can still see like wrinkles, but like if you guys try to do that and you don't have Botox, you can probably have like a way deeper, like I really can't move it that much and I love it. And going up, that's crazy. Like I would have obviously all the lines right there, but when I raise my eyebrows, like obviously I can still raise them and make expressions, but I just don't have wrinkles. All the wrinkles are gone. See? Oh, well, I guess right there a little bit, but that's as much as I can move my forehead. See, but I can still make expressions. So no one has noticed. If you don't have like that expressive of a face, your forehead might just move that much anyway. But I had a very expressive face. So we just did that. And see, these little things just make me feel better, more confident. I just like the way I look that way. And again, like I'm on video and photo all the time. So if it's just something I wanna do for me, that's fine by me. And yeah, I've talked for so long. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. So my worst purchases, some of my best purchases, the worst of times and the best, what is that phrase? Anyway, I really hope this helped steer you in the right direction. I hope that you learned some lessons here. Don't make the mistakes I did. I hope you found some of your new favorite things. Because if you don't have one of the best things I talked about, get out and stop watching my videos because you need it to be a part of the club. No, you don't. It's not about things, people. It's not about the materials. Okay, we all know. I'm kidding. Relax. No one get mad at me. They are just my favorite things that I have, obviously, because they came to my mind right away. But love you guys so much. Thank you for watching. I'm going to end off this video here. It's the longest video of all time. Love you. And I'll see you in my next video. Bye.